Let's suppose you are attending a Danish Christmas party. A very traditional game to play is called pakkelejr, or the game of presents. Each guest is expected to bring a gift, which is then placed in a pile. Then the players take turns rolling dice, and whoever got a 6 can choose any present from the pile. Let's say only the ones who don't yet have a present will continue to play, and the game continues until everyone is seated happily with a gift. But wait! At the end of this round, one of the Vikings ended up with the same gift he brought. That does not sound like a lot of fun. An ideal scenario would entail that no present ends up with the same person who brought it. Turns out, such a situation has a fun name and is called derangement. Spoiler alert, when counting the probability of a derangement, we will come across the number E, even though that might not seem intuitive at first. Let's get to it. We will fix the present order as shown above. Now, without even thinking about it, let's just show all the possible permutation of the four presents. Lucky for us, it's only 4 factorial, or 24 of them. Derangement is the permutation in which no presents appear in their original places. For each permutation, let's count the number of presents that actually are in their original place, such as yellow is the first, blue is the second, green is the third, and red is the fourth. Now, when we think about it, it'll probably be easier to count the number of non-derangements and subtract it later from the total number of permutations. One thing to immediately notice is that if the yellow present appears in its right place, it does not prevent the blue one from being in the right place as well. We can display the number of non-derangements in the Venn diagram, where the overlaps between the circles mean that the both positions are occupied with the correct presents. Those overlaps are the reason that the calculation is not immediately straightforward, and we have to carefully consider such cases. First, let's start simple. What is the number of permutations where at least one present is in its original position? Well, when one present is fixed, that happens in n minus factorial cases, meaning that the rest of the presents can be shuffled as they please. And we can choose one position to fix it in n ways. This n technically comes from it being the number of one combinations, or a selection of one thing taken from n objects without repetition. Should we just stop here and call it a day? Of course not. As mentioned before, the overlaps between the sets is something we have to consider. While counting the permutations with the right placement of the blue present and the right placement of the red present, we accidentally counted twice the cases in which both the blue and the red present are in the right spot. Looks like we gotta subtract the number from the previous term. And what would the number be? As before, we have a two combination of ways to select the two colors from n, and that comes with all the possible permutations of the remaining presents. You already guessed that considering yet another position comes with another complication. Now we subtracted too many and have to add all intersections of three circles back. Such a sequence will continue until we run out of colors. Let's see how we can write it in a more compact form. We express the iterated minus with a minus 1 in a power of k. Notice how there is also a minus in front of the sum. Once we write our binomial coefficient in its explicit form, the expression becomes even more simple. Since n factorial does not depend on k, we take it outside. Now remember that initially we were interested in the number of derangements, thus we subtract this expression from the total number of permutations. When talking about the probability of a derangement, we'll get rid of n factorial altogether by dividing by it. After a few more simplifications, we arrive at something even more cute and compact, looking more and more suspiciously organized. A fun thing to do now is to simply open up the sum again and explicitly look at the individual terms we ended up with. We'll set the minus 1 aside and plot the functions as dependent on x. The first term is just a boring line, while the consecutive terms start being more complex, representing different powers of x. We can sum them all up and plot the resulting function. But wait a second. No wonder that equation looked familiar before. It's a well-known approximation of an e to the power of x. Now, after we remembered that x was supposed to be minus 1, everything falls into place. The sum we wrote above is a pretty good approximation of e to the power of minus 1. In conclusion, the probability of every Viking going home with a lovely unexpected gift is about 0.37. The odds are a bit on the lower side. And note how this would not depend on the number of guests you decided to invite. Thanks for watching. Reach out if you have any questions.